atomic bomb.
The free nations face a worldwide threat. It must be met with a worldwide defense.
Hello everyone and welcome to Axis and Allies 1951. For today's video, we'll be doing a brief introduction of the overall game and the game setup. So here's a quick look at the map. So Axis and Allies 1951 begins in January 1951, just after China enters the Korean War. And basically what happens is when they enter the war, instead of the US forces escaping the Chosin Reservoir, the Chinese are able to cut off and destroy them, which then prompts President Truman to authorize MacArthur to use atomic weapons if he feels it'll improve the situation in Korea. With this sort of vague order, MacArthur launches one atomic attack against Chinese forces in Manchuria. And, you know, got our little atomic bomb token, and we're just kind of flipping that over to show that the territory was actually attacked, which now has prompted, obviously, the Soviet Union to enter the war. And the warring factions for this game are the United States, NATO, the Soviet Union, and Red China. There are, in this game, there are more neutrals, because as the European empires began to break up, some of them went strict neutral. Some of the strict neutrals from World War II started leaning to one side or the other. So just temporarily for right now, we have these different markers. If it's a white marker, it's pro-ally or pro-United States, whatever you want to call it. If it's got a black dot, then it is a pro-communist. And then if a neutral doesn't have anything, then it's strict neutral. Even if like it says pro-ally, if there's no marker, then it's a strict neutral. The only issue that for right now, until we get the right pieces, is Egypt and Alexandria. Because in 1950, Egypt elects a new government that is very anti-British and pretty much kicks the British out of Egypt. However, the British still maintain control of the Suez Canal, so NATO and Allied ships can still move through the canal. Some of the neutral nations have, obviously they have militaries. So some of them, we use the German infantry to represent their military power. There are some neutrals that, as time has moved on since World War II, have increased their military capacity. So some of the neutrals have had their military numbers increased. And that is why, you see like the German pieces on them, at least the German infantry on the board. They're just sort of to represent the neutral nation's military power if they hadn't been upgraded. So like here in Syria is neutral, but it is pro-communist. And it's got three defenders. Whereas Afghanistan is a strict neutral, but we didn't give it any more military, so it's still at a four. Another neutral, though we are using it, we are using the Republic of China symbol, but Formosa or Taiwan, and they have two neutrals. Or not two neutrals, excuse me. two defenders. So basically when this game starts, there obviously is conflict. While the pieces are not here because it was pretty cluttered. I mean, we have fighting in Germany and southern Germany, and those, as you can see by the markers here, are represented over here on the battle boards, or the army boards is what we're calling it right now. We might change the name. But so... and you can use these at any time with the little markers if you want to. So each, outside of the Chinese, each faction has an army board and a naval task force board. Sorry for the glare. That's probably not really ever going to change. Next, there is the option for research and development, and I will go into more detail about that. The cards are a little rough, but again, hopefully one day we'll be able to upgrade that just a little bit. But so that is an overall look of the board game itself. Like I said, I will go into, in subsequent videos, I'll go into more details about each of the warring nations and what their situation is at the beginning of the war, and just sort of their starting positions in more detail.
And then in about a week and a half or so, I will be playtesting with a buddy of mine, Airsoft Commando, and we will post updates throughout the playtest if anyone has any suggestions for the game throughout it. You know, please leave a comment. We have documents detailing like the upgraded rules, some of the upgraded rules that we came up with, and the basic setup and stuff. So if anyone's interested in looking it over, link in the send me your email in the comments or something like that, and you can take a look at it. We're always looking for people's opinions and ideas to help try and make this game a little better. So everyone, hope you've enjoyed the video, and have a good day.